In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters, scattered throughout the world, to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor, through Christ our Lord. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him and all the ages. To him be glory and power through every age, forever and ever. Amen. By his holy may Christ the Lord may the light of Christ, rising in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds.
the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Exultet jam angelica turba celorum, exultent divina mysteria, et protanti regis victoria, tuba in sonet salutaris. Gaudeat et telas, tantis irradiata al fulgoribus, et eterni regis splendore illustrata, totius orbis essentiat, amisisse caliginem. Letetur et mater ecclesia, tanti luminis adornata fulgoribus, et manis populorum vocibus, hec aula resultet. Quae propter a santes vos, fratris carissimi, ad tamiram huius sancti luminis claritatem, unam ecum, cesso Dei omnipotentis, misericordiam invocate. Ut qui me nom meis meritis, intra levitarum numerum, dignatus est aggregari, luminis sui claritatem infundis, cere iuis laudem in plere perficiat. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, His Son, His only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the Eternal Father, and pouring out His own dear blood, wipe clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace, and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us. Oh, love, oh, charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. Oh, truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned for us so glorious a Redeemer. Oh, truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, the night shall become bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me, and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor. A fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees, to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray to you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets. Christ, your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please extinguish your candles carefully.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the Word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these the last days has sent his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. And God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days, and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky. And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the waters of the sea, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things on the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image, and in the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Full of the goodness of the Lord. nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heavens the Lord looks down, he sees all mankind. The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down, he sees all mankind.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of the ages, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac, and two of his servants as well, and with the wood he had cut for the holocaust, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go on over yonder. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon Abraham took wood for the holocaust and laid it on his son Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," Isaac said. "Yes, son," he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the holocaust?" "Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the holocaust." Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," the messenger said. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by his hands in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as holocaust in place of his son. Abraham named the site Yahweh Yireh. Hence the people now say, on the mountain the Lord will see. Again the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashores. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies. And in your descendants, all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command. The word of the Lord.
Let us pray. O God, supreme Father of the faithful, who increased the children of your promise by pouring out the grace of adoption throughout the whole world, and who through the paschal mystery make your servant Abraham, father of nations, as once you swore, grant, we pray, that your peoples may enter worthily into the grace to which you call them, through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you lift up your staff, and with the hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed, without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it unto a panic, and he so clogged their chariot wheels, and they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn, the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea. Then the Lord hurled them into its midst as the water flowed back. It covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped, but the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord, "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory.
sing to the Lord, for he gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. He is my God, I praise him. The God of my Father, I exalt him. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. The Lord is a warrior, Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and army has he hurled into the sea. The elite of his officers were submerged in the Red Sea. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. The flood waters covered them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, magnificent in power. Your right hand, O Lord, has shattered the enemy. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. You brought in the people you redeemed and planted them on the mountain of your inheritance, the place where you made your seat, O Lord, the sanctuary, Lord, which your hands established. The Lord shall reign forever and ever. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory.
Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright, through Christ our Lord.
Oh,
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind we may render you undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If, then, we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Most Reverend Father, I bring you a message of great joy. The message of Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead and is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there you will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, Jesus Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia. I welcome you here this evening on this glorious night to the Cathedral of St. Jude the Apostle. In a special way, I also welcome those who are listening this evening on Spirit FM and by means of live stream. In a particular way tonight, I welcome the elect who are present here with us tonight, as well as your families and friends who gather with you for this very, very special night. It is good to have you here. And tonight, not only do you rejoice in the sacraments that you will receive, but the entire church, this parish, rejoices as well. I'm always struck by the way this beautiful liturgy this evening begins. As you know, the cathedral is in darkness, and we begin outside with the lighting and the blessing of the Easter fire. From that Easter fire, the Paschal candle, the Easter candle, is lit. And it is then processed into the dark cathedral. But that light, which is the light of Christ, pierces that darkness. It pierces the darkness of our sin. And that light is shared from one to the other until the whole cathedral is bathed in its beautiful light, the light of Christ. This evening, this liturgy is in many ways a homily or a sermon itself if we are attentive to what is happening around us. And so I am glad that you are here this evening, and I invite you in a spirit of prayerfulness to enter into the sacredness of this night and of this special liturgy. Our gospel reading from the Gospel of Matthew, just proclaimed by our deacon, of course recounts how the two women went to the tomb early in the morning. And you know, this is a reading which we read often, particularly at Easter. But I have to say, in reading and preparing for this homily this evening and reading this passage from the gospel, there was something that really kind of jumped out at me, something I really maybe had not paid too much attention to before. And it was the verse in the gospel which says, this is after they had gone to the tomb, they encountered the angel who announced the good news to them that Jesus had been risen, as he had said. And then verse 8, and this is in the 28th chapter of Matthew's gospel, it says, then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful, yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. They went away quickly from the tomb, fearful, yet overjoyed, to announce this to his disciples. It is understandable that they would have had some sense of fear at what they had just witnessed, and maybe not fully understanding what they had just seen. But yet the other sense, the other emotion within them, was one of joy. They were fearful, yet overjoyed, and they didn't hesitate. It says they ran to announce this good news, that Jesus had indeed been raised, as he had said, to the disciples. They encounter Jesus on the way there, and he says to them, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Perhaps sensing their fear, their trepidation, he calms their fears. Do not be afraid, and instructs them himself, go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. I say to you tonight, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid to have a close and personal relationship with Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior. Do not be afraid to live the life that he has called us to live. Do not be afraid to go and to announce, to run, and to spread the good news that Jesus Christ is Lord. And because of his suffering and death, our sins are forgiven, and the gates of heaven are once again open to us. Do not be afraid to live the life that I have called you to live. That's what he says to each of us this evening as well. Tonight is truly a night of joy and a night of hope. Last year, our Holy Father, in his homily at the Easter Vigil in St. Peter's Basilica, said this, quote, brothers and sisters, our hope has a name, the name of Jesus. He entered the tomb of our sin. He descended to those depths where we feel most lost. He wove his way through the tangles of our fears, bore the weight of our burdens, and from the dark abyss of death restored us to life and turned our mourning into joy. Let us celebrate Easter with Christ. He is alive. Today, too, he walks in our midst, changes us, and sets us free. Brothers and sisters, our hope has a name, Jesus Christ. He is the source of hope in our lives. By his death and resurrection, he has overcome sin and death, and that should always be a source of great joy to each one of us. To the elect tonight, I hope and I pray that tonight your hearts are filled with joy. And I hope tonight you have a great sense of hope for the future, for the life that you will live after receiving these beautiful sacraments tonight. Do not be afraid to embrace the grace that God gives you tonight. In the waters of that baptismal font, you will die to sin and rise from those waters to newness of life. What a great gift that is. Tonight, whatever sins you have committed are forgiven in the waters of that font. Praise be to God. Receive God's grace tonight with joy and with gratitude in your hearts. Go forward from this cathedral tonight, a new person born in Jesus Christ and sent to preach the good news to all that you meet and encounter in your lives. My brothers and sisters, this Easter, our hope has a name, and that name is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen. My dear friends, let us pray to Almighty God for our brothers and sisters who are asking for baptism. He has called them and brought them to this moment. May he grant them light and strength to follow Christ with resolute hearts and to profess the faith of the Church. May he give them the new life of the Holy Spirit, whom we are about to call down upon this water.
Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Holy angels of God,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph, Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene,
pray for us.
Saint Stephen, Saint Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Basil,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Saint Benedict,
pray for us.
Saint Francis and Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful. From all evil,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
From every sin,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
From everlasting death,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your incarnation,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your death and resurrection,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Be merciful to us sinners,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Bring these chosen ones to new birth through the grace of baptism.
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God,
Lord, we ask you, hear our prayer.
Christ,
Father, you give us grace through sacramental signs, which tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a rich symbol of the grace you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed on the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Spirit. Your Son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, "Go out and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Father, look now with love upon your church and unseal for it the fountain of baptism. By the power of the Holy Spirit, give to this water the grace of your Son, so that in the sacrament of baptism, all those whom you have created in your likeness may be cleansed from sin and rise to a new birth of innocence by water and the Holy Spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the waters of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism rise also with him to newness of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. My dearly elect, I now ask you to profess our faith by these questions, and I ask that you affirm your belief in our faith by responding, "I do," to each one. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Amanda, is it your will and desire that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Yes. Amanda, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Molly, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed?
Yes.
Molly, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Deborah, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Deborah, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Sophia, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? You ready? Anna Sophia, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is it your will that Zachary be baptized in the faith which we have just professed?
Yes.
Zachary, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed?
Yes.
Melody, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bella, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Bella, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gabrielle, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed?
Yes.
Gabrielle, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
You have been baptized.
Jalissa, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Jalissa, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Yes. Mark, I baptize you. Amen. Bob, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed?
Yes.
Bob, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dinesia, is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Dinesia, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is it your will that you be baptized in the faith that you have just professed?
Yes.
Carol, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Is it your will that you be baptized in the faith which you have just professed? Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, you have become a new creation and have clothed your. Receive this baptismal garment. Jesus Christ. Life. My dear brothers and sisters, you have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light and keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. When the Lord comes, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. Dear newly baptized, born again in Christ by baptism. You have become members of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us. The Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit which you are to receive will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. My dear friends, let us pray to God our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on these newly baptized to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Joan of Arc, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. God bless you. Erasmus, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Mary, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Francis of Assisi, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Cecilia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Isidore of Seville, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Teresa of Calcutta, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Catherine Drexel, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Mary of Guadalupe, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Wait,
declare Teresa of Avila be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Therese of Lisieux, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please step forward. Sorry. Teresa of Avila, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Monica, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
With your spirit.
God bless you. Why don't we show our love and support for our newly baptized and confirmed. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. So I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us the forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Lord delights to provide for his people. Now, trusting in his goodness, let us offer our prayers this night.
The response is, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Strengthen the church. May God's great love draw many souls to his Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Move the hearts of all in authority to serve in humility, always protecting the innocent and the most vulnerable. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Bring hope to people suffering from chronic illness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Encourage our faith community as we celebrate Christ's resurrection. May he lead us to new life as disciples. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant every needed blessing to the parishioners of the Cathedral of St. Jude the Apostle. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Bless those who have died in faith. May Christ welcome them with joy into his heavenly kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And let us now offer the prayers and petitions we hold in the silence of our hearts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Father, all power in heaven and on earth is yours. Please hear and answer our prayers in your wisdom through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
As the dawn.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may by the working of your power bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, especially St. Jude the Apostle, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also, Lord, your servants reborn in baptism, whom you have been pleased to confirm by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and in your mercy, keep safe in them your grace.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. This day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. I could ask you to just be seated for a few moments. Just want to, before the final blessing, to say thank you to so many who have made this a very special celebration tonight. First of all, to our music ministers and to our beautiful cathedral choir. Thank you so very, very much. I do want to thank all of our ministers this evening, our readers, excuse me, as well as our altar servers and my MC, Father Ralph, and our deacons. They did a great job tonight. Thank you for your ministry. Also want to express gratitude to Charmaine Carter and to the RCIA team who has accompanied our newly baptized to this point. You did a great job. You must feel like a proud parent this evening, right? Thank you so much. And we're not going to sing tonight, but I do want to just let you know and maybe ask that you offer up a prayer in gratitude for the life of Monsignor John Sipple, who celebrates his 90th birthday today. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Happy Easter, everyone. God bless you.